आपने बाहर से दाल बनाने का जो काम किया 425 रुपए अरहर पर उड़द पर ये तीनों दालों के दाम बढ़ाए आपने सेल हो रहा जीरो इंपोर्ट में आपने गेहूं को 10% ही बढ़ाया मैं उस पर नहीं कहना चाहता लेकिन किसानों ने ये शरद पवार जी बैठे हैं जहां पूरी मेहनत करके सदन ने पूरी सरकारों ने यूपीए सरकार ने 33% ही दाल के किसान जो है उनको उत्पादन
बढ़ाया
इतनी मेहनत करके जान सटा करके किसानों ने उत्पादन किया उसकी कीमत नहीं मिल रही है डिस्टेंस चल हो रहा इसलिए सरकार से कहूंगा
शॉर्ट ड्यूरेशन डिस्कस हो जाएगा
देश के 150 से ज्यादा किसान संगठन आज जंतर मंतर पर बैठे हुए कल से पूरे देश के और जैसा कि शरद यादव जी ने कहा है
इसलिए हम डिस्कशन करना है
समस्या पूरा देशव्यापी है लेकिन सरकार मौन है हम लोग आपसे अनुरोध करते हैं मैंने रूल 267 में अनुरोध भी किया है इस पे डिस्कशन का अगर आपने अगर इसको स्वीकार किया है
गंटे प्रेस मीट होता बोमन कर्नाकर रेड्डी
कीमत मिलने के बजाय गोलियां दी जा रही हैं किसानों के जैसा आपने इंपोर्ट ड्यूटी का एक भ्रष्टाचार का बहुत बड़ा माध्यम बन चुका है जब उत्पादन बढ़ता है तो इंपोर्ट ड्यूटी जीरो कर दी जाती है और उससे सर दिस व्हाट आई एम सेइंग प्लीज एक्सेप्ट इट एज सून एज पॉसिबल लिस्टेड फॉर टुमारो सर लिस्टेड फॉर टुमारो पूरे देश के किसान आए हुए हैं और वहां पर आंदोलित कर रहे हैं
पड़ गया था इतने देश के किसान
और तो उनके बच्चे आए हैं किसानों के बच्चे जो खुदकुशी किए हैं उनकी दारुण कथा सुनिए उनकी दारुण कथा सुनिए तो ये हो रहा है 1,08,00,000 करोड़ रुपया एनपीए का जमा है कॉर्पोरेट घरानों के पास बड़े बड़े सरमाएदार बच्चे आए थे उनकी विधवाएं आई थी
Let me come back to 267. No, that's what I'm saying. We are going to our discussion. Yes. Yeah. Today, see, today, no, but, today, no, see, today, no, please listen. मैं बोलने वाला हूँ उसके बारे में सुनिए सुनिए I am going to say on that अब सुनिए yes आप बैठिए बोलेंगे ठीक है sit down now listen please today we are having a short duration discussion you know it already and the next subject is already decided and that is Kisan's problem very important very serious I will report to chairman yes yeah our discussion now with regard to this Kisan matter that is agrarian distress number of 267 notice were there I will read out the name but since we have slated a discussion I am not allowing 267 to be raised but the notice were given by Sri Anand Sharma Sri Sharad Yadav Sri Pramod Tiwari, Sri Naresh Agarwal, Professor Ram Gopal Yadav, then Sri Gulam Nabi Asad is on Dalit issue which is coming today. Sri Raja is on Dalit issue, a minority issue which is coming today. Sri Pramod Tiwari, yes. Then Kapil Sibal, then Sridhar Amichuri. These are the notices received. On which one?
On 267, sir, I have given twice.
That is not in the list.
Sir, it is there. I
will examine it.
He is
there.
Sir,
if you say you are given, I am not disputing it. I will examine it. Okay.
Sir, what
Anyhow, you said I allowed you to speak. Anyhow, you spoke. So now let me come back to zero-hour submissions. Let me come back to zero-hour submission. Yeah, your zero-hour is there. Let me come back. Let me come back to zero-hour submission. A.K. Selvaraj.
Respected Deputy Chairman, sir.
No, that is not on this issue.
No,
that is not permitted. That is not permitted at all. No. That's what I am saying. That is quite a different subject. That's a different subject. You repeat it. You can repeat that. No, I am not reading out all names. You repeat the notice. Okay, all right, sit down. Now, Sri Selvaraj, nothing else will go on record. Selvaraj, that will not go on record. Sri
Selvaraj. Deputy Chairman, sir, the students of Tamil Nadu were agitating against NEET since its announcement. Yes, they were all the students on basis of state syllabus. Now, all of students moving. Sudden moving to some other syllabus cannot
not going
be
on
accepted
record.
For the purpose of NEET.
That is not going
therefore,
on record.
The
sit down.
Properly
sit down. I not permitted
a bill.
You repeat the notice if you want.
Bill. The bill seeking exemption of for Tamil Nadu students from the NEET was unanimously passed in State Assembly in January 2017 and it was sent to the Centre for Presidential Assent but till date there has been no response. The NEET was against the interest of Tamil Nadu students aspiring for MBBS admission and that the test was based on Central Board of Secondary Education. But 98% of Tamil Nadu students had studied on state syllabus. The question was asked out of the syllabus in public examinations. The students from Tamil Nadu may not be able to answer them properly. In such a situation, it was not acceptable to compel the Tamil Nadu students to write NEET examination, which would be based on CBSE syllabus. The aspiring students have been left in the lurch due to the inaction
Mr.
of the
Rapalu,
NEET bill.
Sit down.
Therefore, I urge upon the government
don't
to
do that.
Presidential
sit down.
Assent to
Rapalu,
the NEET bill
down.
On the Tamil Nadu
what
government immediately to save the future of lakhs of students from Tamil Nadu. Thank you, sir.
Sit down, Rapalu. Yes. Can you move to associate 1 minute? I will allow. Can you move to associate? Srimadhi Kani, sit down. Srimadhi Kani, would you to associate 1 minute?
Yes.
Take 1 minute.
Sir, actually, the Tamil Nadu Assembly has passed a unanimous law and they've sent it to the central government and the president has not given any assent to it. So the problem is, it was said that the Tamil Nadu government wanted 1 year exemption from this exam. That is not true. The Tamil Nadu government and all the political parties in Tamil Nadu want a permanent exemption from this NEET. We do not want NEET examinations for our students. And there was a standing committee recommendation also which said states which did not want to be part of the NEET examinations have to be exempted. The infrastructure in medical colleges, government medical colleges, was developed by the state government, the consecutive state governments, for the students in Tamil Nadu.
See,
you're taking
Krishan.
Away all the seats. You're
See,
depriving
now,
our Krishan. Students of the seats which
Sir, Nandit Krishan.
Developed by our state governments.
Sri Nandit Krishan. One minute. You take 1 minute.
Now the young boys and girls are on the verge of committing suicide. Two set of questions have been framed. ECR questions was distributed to the northern states and the tough question paper was given to the Tamil Nadu students. Hence, they are not able to secure more marks. This is a total discrimination. So, I urge, especially our Honorable Finance Minister, to take appropriate steps to get the assent of the President. Please do a needful and save the young children. Thank you, sir.
Sri Rangarajan. Rangarajan, please. Anybody sit down, you are your say.
Sir,
Rangarajan.
My associate, he wanted to tell, I wrote a letter to the President of India, why he has not given assent to the Tamil Nadu resolution.
No, you
president,
cannot question the
president.
President
of wrote to me.
Don't make such statements here. Please, that is not permitted.
Home Minister.
That is not permitted.
Home
that sentence is wrong. You cannot make such statements here.
I will complete.
No, that is expense.
Only 5% of the Tamil Nadu board student may get.
Don't bring in honorable president here at all.
No.
Yeah, I will. Yes, expense.
I did not mention any name.
Okay, for all that.
Sir, 5% Tamil Nadu board student may get. Sir, we have 22 government medical colleges. This is 22 government medical colleges. 1,000 foreigners. Two state students has been wrote the examination. Only 5% will get. This 50% of the questions are out of the syllabus. 50% of the question out of the syllabus. Is this a way of cooperative?
Okay, all right. Now sit down.
Assembly passes the resolution.
All right.
But section is not yet to accept that. What type of cooperative?
Now sit down, please. All of you sit down. Okay, fine. What is your point of order? What's your point of order?
Sir, my point of order is this, that under the constitutional scheme of things, when a bill is sent to the president for assent, the president does not take normally the decision. The cabinet, the government of the day has recommended and expressed a view. So the government must make it clear, rather than passing it on to the president.
No, they
did
not pass
the president of India in a dock.
It is only members, sir.
People are educated. The HRD minister should clarify. It is not the president. What is the government's view on that?
Okay.
Let the government clarify.
Yes, Raja. 1 minute, Raja. 1 minute, Raja.
I urge upon the Union government to give exemption to Tamil Nadu. Otherwise, it will adversely affect all the...
All right. Excellent. Now, Sri Ali Anwar Ansari.
Sir.
All of you sit down.
Sri Ali Anwar Ansari. Sir.
Yes. All of you sit down.
Sit down, Minister. Sit down, sir. Let the minister react. You don't want the answer. Sit down. Yes. Minister, please. Minister, would you like to say something?
Okay. Sit down. Now, after the minister.
Tamil Nadu ke sabhi... Yeah. As far as Tamil Nadu is concerned, we have discussed, practically everybody has met us.
Please.
अरे दोनों में बोल सकता हूँ लेकिन साथ में दो भाषा में नहीं बोल सकता.
Please. बोलो.
See, as far as Tamil Nadu and NEET issue is concerned, we have discussed with everybody concerned. The matter is at advanced stage and is sub judice. We and the health ministry are also in touch. And so, we have taken note of everybody's plea.
Thank you. Sri Ali Anwar Ansari. Nothing else will go on record. Ali Anwar Ansari. All of you sit down. Ali Anwar Ansari. Nothing else will go on record. Only what Ali Anwar Ansari says will go on record. Sir, they are creating problem. Why should they create problem? Go back. If you go back to your seat. Please go back to your seat. No. Navneet Krishnan. Navneet Krishnan. Listen. No. Listen to me.
No, please. No, no, Sunil. Are, please listen. You had your chance. I allowed all of you. Now you are blocking others. It is unfair. It is unfair. It is unfair. It is unfair. See, Minister, see, you did not hear the Education Minister. Education Minister said they are at it. They are examining it. He has already said that. Did you not hear that? Please, I will not adjourn. Ali, you say nothing else will go on record. Ali Anwar Ansari, you say loud. Speak loud.
Manual scavenging. Suniye, ye amanviya pratha. सर पर महिला धोने की प्रथा हजारों साल से जारी है। मैनुअल स्कैवेंजिंग को सरकार ने इलीगल घोषित किया है। सर अगर देखिए, सर देखिए महिला धोने की प्रथा सर महिला धोने की प्रथा जो है मैनुअल स्कैवेंजिंग ये सरकार ने इलीगल घोषित किया हुआ है
निदिला,
और उसके बाद ये बदस्तूर जारी है सर। भटोरनी में जो दिल्ली के पास है, पिछले शनिवार को चार लोग सेप्टिक लैट्रिन में उतरते हैं और जहरीली गैस से उनकी मृत्यु हो जाती है। चारों दलित हैं और सर सर पिछले ढाई साल में सर पिछले बहन जी पिछले ढाई साल में 2,500 दलित लोग देश में इसी तरह से उनकी मृत्यु हुई है, लेकिन एक भी मुकदमा किसी के खिलाफ नहीं दर्ज किया गया है, मुआवजा भी नहीं देता सर। सर ये सिर्फ कानून की किताब का शोभा बन रहा है सर, कानून की किताब का शोभा बन रहा है।
बोलिए बोलिए।
और ये पूरे पूरे देश में एक राज्य की बात नहीं है, पूरे देश में ये घटनाएं हो रही हैं और उसके लिए सरकार के अंदर कोई संवेदना नहीं है सर। ये सरकार दलित की बात करती है और बहुत ढिंढोरा पीटती है दलित को लेकर के, और पिछली सरकार से भी हमारी शिकायत है, ये पूरी व्यवस्था से शिकायत है, उनकी कोई उनका कोई सुनता नहीं है। ये लाख उनकी डेड हो जाती है जब इंसान मानव दूसरे मानव का मैला सर पर धोता है, नाले की सफाई करता है, तो उसका ये नाक खत्म हो जाता है, डेड हो जाता है, और वो जहरीली गैस से मर रहा है। कोई मशीन नहीं, कोई अपरेटस नहीं, कोई मशीन नहीं। ये क्या करते हैं? ये विकास की बात कर रहे हैं, चंद्रमा पर जाने की बात हम लोग कर रहे हैं, लेकिन एक इंसान इसमें हिंदू भी है, इसमें मुसलमान भी है, हिंदू का हलखोर है तो मुसलमान का हलाल खोर भी ये काम करता है, और हमारी संवेदनाएं मर गई है, इस सदन की संवेदना मर गई है, हमारी सरकारों की संवेदना मर गई है, और वो मर रहे हैं, उनकी कोई सुनने वाला नहीं है सर। तो इसलिए हम कहेंगे, पूरे हाउस से अपील करेंगे कि ये किताब कानून की किताब में शोभा बढ़ाने के लिए नहीं है, इस पर अमल किया जाए। आखिर कितने लोग मरेंगे? पिछले 2.5 साल में 2,500 लोग इस तरह से।
ओके, ऑल राइट, थैंक यू, थैंक यू। श्रीडी राजा, ऑल द नेम्स, द होल हाउस इज एसोसिएटेड, यस, all houses associated, no doubt. Sri D. Raja, D. Raja,
yes,
your, I will ask you, go back. No, only if they go back, otherwise don't stand up. Only if they go back to your seat, you stand up, otherwise don't. You cannot do it on pressure.
अली अनवर का बैठो, ये दे रहा है रिप्लाई,
जवाब दे दो ना, खड़े जाओ ना।
Let them go and sit. Minister, wait. Let them go and take the seat. All of you sit down. Now, sit down if you want the minister to react. Sit down. Yes. You want to say something?
Yes. The ministry had initiated that there should be an All India examination, national eligibility examination test, which was supported by Supreme Court, and later it was also supported by all party when we had the meeting. Last year we gave an exemption. This year...
No, again, don't interrupt like that.
This year the NEET examination took place. In between, the Tamil Nadu Legislative Assembly has come out with a bill which has come to the President of India. We have given our viewpoint on this, and the reasons which they have given, we have also replied in that context also. It is with the Honorable President to decide accordingly, and through Home Ministry we are initiating it.
No, Sridhi Raja. Yes, sir. Sridhi Raja. Nothing else will go on record. Only what D. Raja says will go on record. D. Raja, start, please. D. Raja has to start now.
Sir, Anwar, sir.
You start.
Sir, Kani. Sir.
सर, ये हाथ से मेला ढोने वाली प्रथा के बारे में विषय निकला था, तो मैं उसमें अगर आपकी अनुमति हो तो कुछ निवेदन करूं।
You want to react? Yes, please.
अनेक
राजा वो बोलते हैं, आप बैठिए बोलते हैं, बोलिए।
अनेक माननीय सदस्यों ने हाथ से मेला ढोने वाली प्रथा के अंतर्गत अभी भी कुछ लोग काम कर रहे हैं, इसकी जानकारी का ध्यान आकर्षित करते हुए चिंता व्यक्त की है। मैं आपसे आपके माध्यम से निवेदन करना चाहूँगा कि सरकार इस संबंध में जहाँ भी कोई घटना घटती है, राज्य सरकार के साथ संपर्क करके कार्रवाई करती है, और ये जो चार लोग अभी तीन दिन पहले ही सीवेज टैंक की सफाई करते हुए मारे गए हैं, इनके संबंध में भी कार्रवाई जारी है, और अगर इस पर कभी चर्चा होगी तो मैं विस्तृत जानकारी भी दूंगा। इन तीन वर्षों में अर्थात 14-15 के बाद जो घटनाएँ हुई है, उन सब में हमने राज्य सरकार से मुआवजा दिलाया है। कई जगह कुछ राज्य सरकारों ने आपसी समझौता करके सुप्रीम कोर्ट का जो आदेश है 10 लाख रुपए ऐसे व्यक्ति को देने के लिए जो सीवेज टैंक में सफाई करने के लिए उतरता है और मरता है, उसमें समझौता करके कुछ धनराशि कम ज्यादा दिलवाई है, उस पर भी हम कार्रवाई कर रहे हैं। मैं सदन को आश्वस्त करना चाहता हूँ कि जो कानून बना है उसका अक्षरशः पालन करने का हम प्रयास कर रहे हैं और आगे भी करेंगे। माननीय सदस्यों के ध्यान में अगर कोई इस प्रकार की जानकारी हो और नाम हो तो जरूर मुझे लिख करके भेजेंगे, मैं आश्वस्त करता हूं कार्रवाई करूंगा।
फाइन, डी राजा, नाउ डी राजा, अली अनवर सिट डाउन,
अनवर सर,
अली अनवर सिट डाउन, डी राजा, अली बैठो, नॉट गोइंग ऑन रिकॉर्ड, अली बैठो, इट इज नॉट गोइंग ऑन रिकॉर्ड, सिट डाउन, सर, राजा प्लीज स्टार्ट, इट इज नॉट गोइंग ऑन सर, इट इज नॉट गोइंग ऑन रिकॉर्ड, सिट डाउन, अरे बैठिए, अब क्या करते हैं? रिप्लाई भी मिला, फिर भी चिल्लाते हैं, क्या कौन चिल्लाते हैं? बोलो
सर, थैंक यू सर, वेट यस सर,
आई लाइक टू टेक एक्शन अगेंस्ट रापलु, व्हाट इज दिस, नथिंग विल गो ऑन रिकॉर्ड, दैट इज नथिंग बट इनडिसिप्लिन, राजा प्लीज,
सर, थैंक यू सर, आई ड्रा द अटेंशन ऑफ द एंटायर हाउस, राज्यसभा इज द काउंसिल ऑफ स्टेट्स, आई एम हैप्पी दैट एमएचआरडी मिनिस्टर फॉर हायर एजुकेशन इज ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट इज सिटिंग हियर, सर, इन 2004 गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया हैज अकॉर्डेड classical language status to Tamil language. Originally, the functions of the institute were given to the Central Institute of Languages, Indian Languages, Mysore. When Mr. Arjun Singh was minister, on the demand of many political parties and scholars in Tamil Nadu, it was shifted to Chennai. The then Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, Mr. Kalinjar, it was shifted to Tamil Nadu. In the year 2007, the Central Institute for Classical Tamil was instituted in Chennai. Now there are reports in a section of media, these functions of this institute will be transferred to Central University in Tiruvarur. It means this institute will lose its autonomous character, autonomous status, and this is not acceptable to the scholars, the people of Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu, listen to me, sir. And there is a strong apprehension. This is all done keeping in view the ulterior design that to give special status to a couple of languages, maybe Hindi and Sanskrit, and to undermine other languages of the country. And all languages should be treated as national languages. And in this case, the Central Institute for Classical Tamil should remain in Chennai and should function with autonomous status. And the minister must make the position clear. Government should come out clean on this issue. And it should not leave it to domain of speculation. Media is reporting, it is being shifted, it is being attached to the Central University in Tiruvarur, and I am given to understand the Executive Council of Central University has already accepted to take over the Central Institute for Classical Tamil. What is the position? And I urge upon the government, it should remain in Chennai as an autonomous institute. The government should explain.
Yes. Minister.
Let me make at the outset very clear that government has not taken any such decision. We respect all Indian languages, and our effort will be to furthering the cause of all Indian languages, and we are not going to impose any language on anybody.
Okay, fine.
That is. So that therefore, these are not true reports. See, there are always ideas churned out, people discuss, people react, but let me make it very clear that government has not taken any such decision.
Thank you.
Will remain so,
and we
will promote, we want to promote our policy to promote all Indian languages. All Indian languages.
Sri K.K. Ragesh. K.K. Ragesh. It will come. It is there. Don't worry, it is there. No. I go by the order. I go by the list. No. It is not number 3. You are wrong. No. You cannot do it. It is with me. How can you question the list with me? What are you talking? The list is with me. I am going by the order. No, the list is with me only, not with you. It is here only. How can you say that? Why should I called K.K. Ragesh, you have objection? Then K.K. Ragesh withdraw, I will call you. No. So now he has resigned.
Clarify.
He is not minister now. Now please, K.K. Ragesh.
Sir.
Sri K.K. Ragesh.
Sir, workers of the Hindustan newsprint have taken to the streets. Sir.
What is your problem?
Me. I want on this matter, I first of all, thankful.
No, you need not say on this matter. You are not minister.
I only want to
say. You are not minister.
That. Now that the minister has said he will not impose any language on anybody,
yeah.
I would also like to say...
No, you are not minister.
India, If you want to learn Hindi, nobody should stop them from learning Hindi.
Sit down.
Devanagari is not Hindi. These people
should know. No. Sit down. K.K. Ragesh.
Sir.
Subramanian Swamiji, you are not
Thank
minister.
Thank you, sir. Workers of the Hindustan newsprint have taken to the street against the privatization of the central PSU. Yesterday, they have organized a parliament march also against the decision of the central government to privatize the central PSU. Sir, Hindustan newsprint, it is a fully owned subsidiary of Hindustan Paper Corporation. Now, the government had decided for 100% disinvestment of the particular company, Central PSU. Sir, it was a making company till 2011-12, and it had paid 117 crores as dividend to the central exchequer. During the last 4 years, the company is facing certain crises due to the policy of the government. We cannot blame the company for such crises because the government had decided to lift import duty on foreign newsprint, which ultimately led to the crisis of this particular company. And also, repeated request for modernization of the company is also not being taken up seriously. And ultimately, that led to certain crisis in the company. And sir, because of all these things, the company is not in a position to compete with foreign newsprint giants. And that led to the crisis, and it is not the company that responsible, but the policy of the government that responsible for the present crisis. And sir, the company can be made as a profitable company. It is undoubtedly it can be made a profitable company. And a modernization proposal is lying before the government. But unfortunately, the government is not in a position, not ready to accept the modernization proposal lying before it. Sir, the Kerala government had already written, the Chief Minister himself had written a letter to the central government in this regard for retaining that company as a public sector unit. The Kerala State Assembly also unanimously passed a resolution in this regard. But unfortunately, government is not ready to accept the modernization proposal. And sir, why this Hindustan newsprint is being privatized? Not only Hindustan newsprint, all the public sector units in our country are being privatized. Not only the loss-making companies, but also the profit-making companies. They are selling out all the private public sector industries in our country. So far as Kerala is concerned, whatever public sector units are there, all those yes, are being sold out. And I am demanding the government immediately.
No.